Hey everyone, Anthony Fantano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time for a review of the new Deadmau5 record, While One Is Less Than Two. This is the latest LP from famed Ontario electronic music producer and DJ, Deadmau5. One of the biggest names in EDM today, ton of respect for this guy. He's got quite a few singles that I like. However, I was not really looking forward to listening to this new Deadmau5 record, because in my opinion, mainstream, modern, EDM music is not really an album genre. And not that it couldn't be, I just don't see a lot of artists taking that route. To me, a lot of the records that are coming out of modern EDM, and especially Deadmau5's past records, feel just more like compilations, even though he's put out things that are legitimately compilations. His main albums just feel like a collection of tracks that he made from this point in time to this point in time that may not necessarily sound that fantastic together. Everybody keeps saying the album is dead, and yet the album continues to be like this that so many artists continue to play into and release, despite the fact that some of these artists are playing music within genres where it's really singles that reign supreme. And that's the case for Deadmau5. That's the case for modern EDM. It's the live set and it's the single that really continues to advance his popularity. And that's fine. I know how fun a live DJ set can be. Deadmau5 actually tries to work to sort of recreate that experience on this record by giving people tracks that essentially mix and link all the songs on this double album together into an unbroken chain. An interesting idea, I think, but still, there were reasons I was dreading giving this record a listen. For one, it's over 2 hours long. That's a lot of material coming from an artist that I don't really care for when it comes to the album experience. The single and live experience is another story. And I suppose the other thing I've dreaded is, in the past, I've also heard Deadmau5 bring on some pretty terrible plastic and commercial sounding guest singers that I think completely ruin his tracks. However, this new record was not really the one-dimensional and arduous listen that I thought it was gonna be. Joel actually did his best to create a series of songs that are really free of awful guest singers. The only real guest singer on this entire LP is Colleen D'Agostino of the band The Material. But even Joel's usual house-style bangers are a little darker and noisier and glitchier and industrial on this record. A lot of these tracks typically feature some kind of very light, airy, melodic, beautiful interlude too. Joel is writing more dynamic material on this LP. In a way, it kind of reminds me of that John Hopkins album that dropped last year, Immunity, a record that brought very tense, creative, hard-hitting house tracks and incorporated very organic live instrumentation like pianos and some strings as well. I definitely feel an influence from this John Hopkins record, but even more so, I think there's quite a bit of Nine Inch Nails on this LP too. There are some tracks on this record that are just Trent Reznor all the way, from The Downward Spiral to Trent's more recent soundtrack work. The song Somewhere Up Here totally feels like a Nine Inch Nails instrumental. And then there's the very eerie drone and piano on the song COELACANTH too. And Joel isn't even afraid of making this influence incredibly obvious by featuring two remixes that stick out like sore thumbs in the track list, not in a good way, of a Nine Inch Nails song and a How to Destroy Angels song. However, I do find a lot of the other tracks on this LP to be very appealing, and I think a lot of them actually divert away from the more commercial side of Joel's output, like the song RLYEHS, Lament, which is a beautiful little electronic music composition. It's a very pretty track and a song that has me thinking that Deadmau5 really has his ear to some orchestral music on this record, some film scores, and maybe even a little I Care Because You Do era Aphex Twin, like on the song Creep or A Moment to Myself. My only major disappointment with this song is that it fades out so suddenly, and a lot of the songs on the second disc of this record do. This side of the double album tends to be a bit more melodic and gentle, not really setting a continuous groove or anything like that for a DJ set. These two discs actually feel like two totally different albums. While the first disc is fairly straightforward, the second disc to me feels sort of like a soundtrack that doesn't really have a movie to string it together. Even the most hard-hitting, driving beat on this entire record from the song Mercedes feels like it could be set to visuals. It feels very cinematic. I believe there's even some audio of like a train station or a subway station being sampled into this track. There is a very righteous chord progression on this track too that makes the song feel pretty epic. Some of what's on the second disc is pretty gripping, but some of it, I don't know, kind of isn't. There are a lot of guitar and piano interludes on this side of the disc that run a little bland, maybe with the exception of the song Monday, which takes a very familiar chord progression, sets an incredibly sad melody to it, and then there's some singing robot vocals on the back end of the track. It's sort of like a weepy cut that didn't make the new Daft Punk record or something. It's nice to hear Deadmau5 pushing into some more subtle territory, but is the end result amazing? Not really. However, there are some very good bangers on the first disc of this album. I think the opener to this disc is incredibly primal, really dark rhythms on this track. Love it. The second track on here brings a really beautiful interlude that I think is great. As I said, I don't really care for the How to Destroy Angels remix, but pretty much more than two-thirds of the first disc on this record are just really great, creative, colorful house bangers for Joel. A little darker, a little more melodic, a little more textured than usual for him. Some of these tracks are structurally surprising. I think that Joel brings some great grooves, and I love what he does when he usually brings an interlude into the fold with some of these songs too. Now, some of them can run a little long, like 8 or 9 minutes. For me, maybe Joel doesn't bring quite enough progression to the table to keep me on the edge of my seat with these songs from beginning to end, but I still think he's coming through with some of his best material yet on this new record. I'm feeling a 7 on the first disc, feeling a 5 on the second disc. Cool? Cool. Transition, if you've given this LP a listen, what did you think of it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Why? What do you think I should review next? And that's it. Anthony Fantano, Deadmau5.